Hello everyone, how are you all doing today? This is your master teacher Surabhi Gupta from Vedantu, and I would welcome all of you to this amazing, fantastic, very knowledgeable session on the history, the story of Goa. How Goa got liberated, how Goa got freedom, how Goa is one of those only states that does not celebrate Independence Day on the 15th of August. Right, so every year, as you know, we celebrate our Independence Day through parades, through cultural events, through flag hoisting, you know, celebrating the sacrifices of our freedom fighters. But Goa is that one state that, of course, celebrates with us on the 15th of August, but also has its own Liberation Day. The reason for that is that Goa was not occupied by the British, you know, British powers. It was occupied by the Portuguese. The Portuguese were the first major European power to enter India, and they were the last ones to leave. So exactly what kind of rule did they have on Goa? How was it that how was it that they were pushed out of our country because they did not go easy? So कैसे था कि Portuguese को Goa से निकाला गया? इस कहानी को जानने के लिए let us move forward. Now, when we think of Goa, हमें लगता है कि यार क्या beaches है और क्या मतलब मस्ती है दोस्तों के साथ. We never thought that Goa would have such a rich history, right? Goa जो है हमारे country का western part में है and it is along the coastline of the Arabian Sea. It is very popular for its beautiful beaches and frankly for just chilling with your friends. राइट बट एज आई टोल्ड यू बहुत ही इंटरेस्टिंग हिस्ट्री है इसकी और बहुत ही धमाकेदार हिस्ट्री है राइट सो व्हाट एग्जैक्टली हैपेंड द पोर्चुगीज व्हेन इट केम टू इंडिया इट इन्वेडेड गोवा इन 1510 एंड अल्फोंसो डी अल्बुकर्की एक्चुअली वन यू नो गोवा उसके बाद पोर्चुगीज ने इसको 450 ईयर्स तक रूल किया नाउ वन क्वेश्चन दैट शुड कम टू योर हेड इज कि मैम व्हाई डिड दे चूज गोवा राइट व्हाई नॉट केरला और व्हाई नॉट एनी अदर स्टेट The main reason is that Goa first offered a suitable location for expanding the naval powers of Portuguese. Portuguese जो है अपनी naval army ने अपनी naval power को improve करना चाह रहे थे, increase करना चाह रहे थे, and they thought that Goa offers a strategic location. One, because it was on the Malabar coast, right? Second, because और सब जो areas थे उस coast में were already occupied by other, you know, other Indian powers, right? Second, the Portuguese wanted to spread Christianity in India and they thought that Goa offered a good opportunity. The third is that the Portuguese used Goa to earn a lot of profits. Because Goa is a very important port on the Malabar coast. And as you know, especially my 8th standard students, that all the spices would, you know, actually be in great demand in the European market and the Goa port was a very important port through which those spices would actually be transported to the European market, right? However, things worsened after the dictatorship of Antonio de Oliveira Salazar, जो वहाँ के प्राइम मिनिस्टर थे, जिन्होंने पोर्चुगीज़ के बेसिक राइट्स भी लोगों से छीननी शुरू कर दी. Right, he started taking away the right to free speech, the right to assembly, the right to press. The Hindus in Goa were extremely, Hindus and Muslims of Goa were persecuted. They were not allowed to practice their religion. They were not allowed to inherit land. काफी ज़्यादा problems उनको सहनी पड़ी. Christianity was forcefully spread. Right, so all of this started happening. Even जो wedding cards थे, they were also regulated. तो काफी बुरी हालत थी गोवा की under the Portuguese. Now let's understand what happened when India got independence in 1947. What was the position of Goa? So the Portuguese, pehle hame laga ki because in, you know, the British went and other European powers that were there in India, they also left India. So Portuguese bhi khud hi chale jayenge. But aisa nahi hua. They did not leave India even after India became independent from the British colony. Why? Because Portuguese ka claim tha that when we occupied Goa, there was nothing like India, right? And that is why Goa is a part of Portugal. Matlab the proper mainland Portugal ka part hai Goa. So they said that there is no point of returning Goa because Goa is ours, right? Now the confrontation between Portuguese and India eventually started increasing. Portuguese government jo hai kaafi pareshan karne lagi Indian government ko and certain things happened jiske bare mein main aapko bataungi that later on pushed our Indian government to launch the Operation Vijay in 1961 that finally liberated Goa. Now exactly hua kaise ye sab? राइट. सो द फर्स्ट रेजिस्टेंस अगेंस्ट द पोर्चुगीज स्टार्टेड जब एक फ्रेंचमैन जिसका नाम था त्रिस्ताउ डी ब्रिगेंका हु स्टार्टेड यू नो राइटिंग अ पैम्फलेट अबाउट हाउ द पोर्चुगीज रूल इन गोवा वॉज oppressing the people, किस तरीके से वो cruelty कर रहे थे against the Goans, right? And then he also founded the Goa National Congress. बाद में राम मनोहर लोहिया, who was a very important socialist leader of India, visited Goa to meet his friend and writer Julio Menes. And while he was visiting his friend, he looked around and he saw कि काफी ज़्यादा problems में थे हमारे fellow Goans, right? And he advised the national leaders in Goa to start a civil disobedience movement based on means that is non-violent. राइट. तो वहां के जो लोकल लीडर्स थे दे काइंड ऑफ गॉट होप दैट मे बी इंडियंस वुड हेल्प देम एंड दे स्टार्टेड देयर मूवमेंट. दे स्टार्टेड टू प्लान, दे स्टार्टेड टू यू नो स्ट्रेटजाइज. राइट. सो द मूवमेंट क्विकली गेन ट्रैक्शन. काफी लोग जो है, काफी यूथ जो है इस मूवमेंट से अट्रैक्ट हुआ एंड यू सॉ द इमर्जेंस ऑफ आजाद गोमंतक दल. लेटर जो आरएसएस है, राष्ट्रीय स्वयं सेवक संघ आरएसएस, दे ऑल्सो ज्वाइन द एजेडी एंड दिस मूवमेंट बिकेम बिगर एंड बिगर. राइट. नाउ जब इतना एंटी पोर्चुगीज रेजिस्टेंस शुरू हुआ तो पोर्चुगीज चुप तो रहेंगे नहीं. दे ऑल्सो स्टार्टेड अ वेरी हैवी पुलिस क्रैकडाउन अगेंस्ट द रेजिस्टेंट मूवमेंट दैट ऑफन बिकेम वायलेंट. लार्ज पब्लिक गैदरिंग्स वर नाउ बैंड. Because large public gatherings were banned, इससे क्या हुआ कि काफी protests होने लगे around Goa, saying that हम तो protest करेंगे, आप क्या करोगे? Then of course the Portuguese government continued its very harsh cruelty and you know harsh crackdown on the violence. Right? Now post 1947, Indian government ने काफी कोशिश की कि वो Portuguese government से बात करे कि you know come talk to us, let us come to a compromise. But Portuguese government were not interested. उनका काफी clear फंडा था कि गोवा तो हमारा है. When we took over Goa, there was nothing like India. So how can you say Goa belongs to you? Right? Goa was considered to be a part of the Portuguese territory. Now, exactly इस point से हम Day of Freedom तक कैसे पहुंचते हैं? Indian government was initially not fully pushing towards independence of Goa या towards liberation of Goa. Why? क्योंकि international level पे Goa was considered to be a part of the Portugal territory. जो NATO countries थे, जो Western countries थे, they were very strong in saying कि Goa, Portuguese is right. Goa is a part of Portugal और India जो है वो hypocrisy कर रही है. First, you know, by saying that Goa is a part of India. Right? So the Western countries were totally against India, except for USSR. जवाहरलाल नेहरू ने भी काफी कोशिश की कि वो डिप्लोमैटिक एफर्ट से वॉर अवॉइड करे. He was a peace loving man and he wanted to avoid war, he wanted to avoid a battle. तो उन्होंने काफी लोगों से बात की. He went to USA, he went to UK, he tried to talk to the prime ministers and the president, but he could not get a good answer. Right? All the countries were supporting the Portuguese except for a few African countries and USSR. Now, on 15th August 1955, Portuguese government ne fire kiya ek peaceful protest pe, killing 30 people. The world media saw this and criticized the Portuguese for this action. Right? Another event was 24th November 1961. एक वन पैसेंजर बोट, एक नॉर्मल फिशरमैन की बोट जा रही थी बिटवीन द अंजदेवा आइलैंड एंड कोची. पर पोर्चुगीज आर्मी सॉ दिस एंड शॉट एट द वेसल, किलिंग वन फिशरमैन. बस यही मौका था इंडियन गवर्नमेंट को एंड द इंडियन गवर्नमेंट डिसाइडेड टू अटैक द पोर्चुगीज. It brought together its army, air force and navy and prepared for a full and frontal final attack. इस पॉइंट पे भी जवाहरलाल नेहरू जी ने बोला पोर्चुगीज को कि लिसन, वी आर रेडी फॉर अ ट्रूस, आप सरेंडर कर दो, गोवा हमको दे दो एंड वी विल नॉट लॉन्च अ फुल फ्रंटल अटैक ऑन यू. बट रिफ्यूजिंग टू ट्रूस विद इंडिया, एंटोनियो सालाजार, द देन प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफ पोर्चुगीज, गेव एक्सट्रीम ऑर्डर्स ऑफ विन और डाई टू हिज सोल्जर्स. उन्होंने कहा कि बस यही मौका है, विन और डाई, but we will not give Goa to you. This is when Operation Vijay started on 17th of December 1961 when Indian troops captured the northwestern part of Goa and by 18th December most of Goa was captured. जब ये हुआ तो सालाजार ने स्कॉर्च्ड अर्थ मिलिट्री स्ट्रेटजी अपनाने को कही अपने आर्मी ऑफिशियल्स को. That is, he told his army, he told the Portuguese army in Goa that we need to apply the scorched earth military strategy. What is this strategy? काफी interesting strategy है that actually takes place in a lot of battles around the world where if you are losing, you don't lose gracefully. No. You actually leave the land by destroying all the resources of the land. जिससे जो victor है, जब वो land को capture करे, what will he get? Thenga. Right? So after he gave that order, all of these other officials, जो उनके army थे, they started destroying all the resources while falling back. Now, because the Portuguese did not have any good air force in Goa, this gave a huge benefit to our Indian Air Force. With the help of INS Mysore and INS Trishul, we were able to capture Goa and defeat the Portuguese. Operation Vijay was successfully completed in 36 hours, making Goa an integral part of India. On 19th of December, Portuguese Governor Manuel Silva ko dena hi pada ek certificate of surrender. And that is why we celebrate the 19th of December as the Goa Liberation Day. Now, bolna aur padhna bahut aasan hai, Operation Vijay. But all of this was a mixture of the military and diplomatic strategies that our Prime Minister then Jawaharlal Nehru and the other freedom fighters together kind of, you know, made it possible, right? Ye hai a picture of Indian troops entering Panaji, and when they entered Panaji, they were welcomed with a huge round of applause and cheering. And that also showed the entire world that yes, Goa wanted this. Hai na, ye humne jabardasti nahi kiya. But here's the thing. Even after we liberated Goa, even after Goa is today such an important part of India, ki koi question hi nahi kar sakta, Portuguese even today calls the liberation of Goa as annexation of Goa. Aaj tak wo bolte hai ki Goa hamara part tha jo India ne chheen liya, right? And jab ye pura incident hua, Operation Vijay ka, a lot of Western powers were also not happy with India, saying that India bahut hypocrite hai. पहले तो बोलती है non-violence, और फिर violently ही गोवा को अपना पार्ट बना लेती है. But a lot of other countries like Ghana, African countries, USSR said that this is a day of, you know, bright light. This is a day of sunrise. This is a day where Goa has finally gotten independence from the oppressive and cruel rule of the Portuguese. And that is the story of how Goa got liberated on the 19th of December. Oh, also, This is also the reason why 15th of August is not the only day why Goa celebrates Independence Day. You know, the title of the video, right? So if you like this story, let me know in the comment section ki agar aapko iske bare mein pata tha, if you thought this was interesting, do share it with your friends. And of course, if you are new to the channel, do not forget to subscribe. This is your master teacher Surabhi signing out for the day. Bye bye. Have a great day.